Not long ago, a team of marine experts noticed something strange unfolding over a bay off the Russian coast. A crowd of over 50 massive whales had gathered in shallow waters, unusually close to shore. These sea giants all had something in common. Their skin told stories. Some were marked with scrapes and scratches, others carried clusters of parasites, and a few looked downright worn out. Together, these heavyweights started rubbing and scraping their massive bodies against the rocky bottom of the bay, scratching off the bugs, shedding dead skin, and giving themselves a full-body retreat. Experts called it nature's version of a whale's day at the spa, but that's pretty much where the peaceful self-care part of their life ends. According to some sources, these deep-sea titans are the second heaviest creatures on the planet, tipping the scales at a whopping 220,000 pounds and can gulp down more than 4,000 pounds of food in a single day. They thrive in some of the most brutal, freezing waters Earth has to offer and aren't afraid to throw down with some of the ocean's most fearsome predators, like the killer whale. Still, somehow, they continue to live up to 200 years, making them the longest-lived mammals ever known to exist. Meet the mighty Leviathan of the deep, the spellbinding bowhead whale. Back in May 2007, researchers caught a massive 49-foot-long bowhead whale off the Alaskan coast. Lodged deep in its flesh was a 3.5-inch bomb lance head. As the name suggests, bomb lances were explosive harpoons used by 19th-century whalers, designed to tear through a whale's thick hide and detonate it from the inside. It was a savage tool, meant to kill the animal instantly in a violent blast. But somehow, this whale didn't die. Either the harpoon never went off, or it exploded, and the animal powered through the pain, carrying the metal shard inside its body all the way until 2007. The model of the harpoon dated back to somewhere between 1879 and 1885, which meant the whale had likely survived the attack during that same period, making it at least 115 to 130 years old when it was caught. The discovery sparked a wave of curiosity. Scientists dug deeper into the ages of other bowhead whales, and what they uncovered was even more astonishing. Some bowheads were found to be 135 years old, others reached 172, and one individual is even recorded at 211 years of age and still going. A few years later, genetic testing pushed that number even higher, suggesting that bowheads can live up to 268 years, making them the longest living mammals ever known to exist on Earth. Their age, though, is only one of several jaw-dropping traits. We'll get to the rest soon enough, but first, let's give these deep-sea giants the introduction they deserve. Balaena mysticetus, better known as the bowhead whale, also called the Greenland right whale, Arctic whale, or polar whale, is a species of baleen whale from the family Balaenidae, and the only surviving member of its genus. Unlike most whales that migrate between warmer and colder waters throughout the year, this deep-sea heavyweight lives a far more committed life, being the only baleen whale that spends its entire existence exclusively in the icy grip of the Arctic and subarctic seas. As you can imagine, life in these frozen depths isn't exactly easy. The below-freezing temperatures take a serious toll on the prey availability, especially in areas where thick sheets of ice blanket the ocean surface for months at a time. To adapt, these whales make smaller, local migrations within the region, moving wherever the food's more abundant. To survive the cold itself, bowhead whales rely on the thickest layer of fat, called blubber, found in any whale species. In a full-grown individual, this insulating layer can measure between 17 to 19 inches, keeping it warm and shielded throughout the year. Relative to its body, the bowhead whale has the largest head of any known cetacean, making up nearly 40% of its total length. That massive head is also what earned it the name bowhead, and it's strong enough to break through solid ice up to 24 inches thick. A head this large also means an enormous feeding apparatus. As a filter feeder, the bowhead whale feeds by gliding forward with its mouth wide open, letting the ocean do most of the work. Lined along both sides of its mouth are 230 to 360 baleen plates, which act like fine cones. As water flows in, these plates trap tiny prey near the tongue. Then, with its mouth closed, the whale pushes the water back out, this time holding on to every bit of food caught in the filter. These baleen plates can grow up to 13 feet long, longer than any other whale species out there. And to make sure they don't snap from the force of all that water pressure flowing in and out, the bowhead's lower jaw is built with a huge upturned lip that reinforces and cradles the baleen like a natural brace. In a single day, a bowhead whale can consume around 4,000 pounds of food, ranging from krill and copepods to mysids and amphipods and other small crustaceans. And they're not picky about it either. These whales feed wherever the prey is most concentrated. Near the surface, they'll rocket upward with mouths wide, scooping up tons of food while blasting water from their blowholes up to 20 feet into the sky. Then, without missing a beat, they dive right back down, hunting for the next jackpot swarm. This insatiable appetite is necessary to maintain a frame that's just as immense. Being the second heaviest creature to ever exist after the mighty blue whale, adult bowheads are nothing short of colossal. These Arctic giants stretch anywhere from 46 to 66 feet in length and tip the scales at a jaw-dropping 165,000 to 220,000 pounds, with females typically outweighing the males. With a body that massive, the thick layer of blubber, while great for fending off the cold, can actually turn into a bit of a problem when it's time to eat. As the bowhead whale dives and rises, gulping down mouthfuls of tiny prey and pushing gallons of water in and out, all that movement builds up serious internal heat. Even in the freezing Arctic, that kind of strain can wear the big mammal down fast. In such cases, a bowhead whale relies on what's known as a palatal rateal organ, located on the roof of its mouth. It's a dense, spongy cluster of blood-filled tissue that forms two pronounced lobes near the front, and it's made from the same kind of tissue found in a mammal's penis. When the whale is on the move and cranking out a lot of body heat, it simply opens up its mouth and lets the frigid Arctic water wash over the organ, cooling the blood as it passes through and helping regulate its body temperature back to normal. Since its head is massive, the bowhead whale houses a brain that, when fully stretched, can reach an astonishing 44 feet in length, lined with deep, intricate folds. This complex structure hints at powerful cognitive abilities, allowing bowheads to break down incredibly detailed sound patterns, helping them stay fully tuned in to what's happening around them. And that's a must, because bowheads are loud, social creatures. They rely on low-frequency calls to communicate. Bond and alert each other about food hotspots or incoming threats. Between 2010 and 2014, researchers off the coast of Greenland recorded 184 different songs from a population of just about 300 whales. Beyond communication and survival, though, perhaps the most vital role of these songs is tied to reproduction. In fact, scientists can actually pinpoint the whale's mating season based on when its singing hits its peak. Every year, from March to August, these ocean giants gather in groups where one or two females may end up mating with several males. Once a whale conceives, a long gestation period of 13 to 14 months begins, ending with the birth of a single calf every 3 to 4 years. Within just 30 minutes of being born, that baby is already swimming and tipping the scales at 2,200 pounds, while measuring 13 to 15 feet long. Just 1 year later, it can grow up to double that size, reaching 27 feet. A bowhead whale reaches sexual maturity at 10 to 15 years of age and continues to reproduce throughout most of its incredibly long life. In 2015, experts from the US and UK successfully mapped the entire genome of a bowhead whale, identifying two specific genes responsible for its extraordinary lifespan. These genes, called ERCC1 and PCNA, are crucial for repairing DNA and enhancing resistance to diseases like cancer, while also playing a role in slowing down the overall aging process of the bowhead. However, despite all that, even giants like these can't always escape what's coming for them. For bowhead whales, their two biggest threats come from pretty much opposite ends of the food chain: humans and orcas. This particular pod was being observed by a team of marine experts when something shifted. The whales suddenly grew restless, panicked even. and just moments later, a gang of orcas appeared, charging in with chilling precision, ramming into the bowheads, isolating one, and tearing into it in a brutal ambush. Now, bowheads aren't exactly defenseless. They'll whip around with their powerful tails or try to counter with head-on rams, but orcas are faster, slicker, and meaner. More often than not, it's the bowheads who end up bleeding in the water, added to the orca's menu. And as if that wasn't enough, humans have been a major part of the bowhead's struggle for survival too. For centuries, they were hunted for everything. Blubber, oil, bones, baleen, and meat. By the early 1900s, before whaling bans were put in place, commercial hunts had pushed many regional populations of these massive whales to the edge of extinction. But in recent decades, with tougher laws and conservation efforts kicking in, bowhead numbers have started bouncing back. Today, they're listed as least concern on the IUCN Red List, and somewhere between 10,000 and 18,000 of these gigantic mammals gliding through the frosty, bone-chilling Arctic seas. Speaking of frosty waters, scientists have recently pointed out that bowhead whales have lost a big chunk of their genetic diversity over the past 500 years. All because they've stayed holed up in the Arctic and subarctic waters for so long. What that means is, if they ever try to venture out into the open waters now, they could end up losing their crown as the longest living mammals, or at the very least, shave off a good chunk of that epic lifespan. Their bodies just aren't built for the warmer, more unpredictable climates anymore. It's kind of like spending your whole life in a perfectly air-conditioned room, then suddenly being thrown into the middle of a desert with no sunscreen. Yeah, good luck with that. Anyway, it's not like the bowheads are lining up to make a tropical getaway anytime soon, so maybe we're in the clear for now. Are we? What do you think? Let me know in the comments below, and as always, I'll catch you in the next one.